Hello, I'm Dr. Vaughn Cook. I've worked in the complementary and alternative health and wellness field for over 30 years. And for a large portion of that time, I've been dedicated to the research and development of biocommunication technology, studying the way the body and the mind communicate. The human body and mind are so vast, complex, and fascinating. You're a lot smarter than you think. In fact, conscious thinking is too slow to keep up with most of us. Thinking, for the most part, occurs in the frontal cortex. In this part of your brain, you process approximately 2,000 pieces of information every second. In this part of your brain is a mechanism called the reticular activation system, or RAS. The RAS acts like a very efficient secretary who screens all of your calls. The reason you need this is because you have so much going on below the level of your conscious mind in your subconscious self. During that second, when you're consciously processing up to 2,000 pieces of information, your subconscious self is processing over 400 million pieces of information. With all this subconscious activity going on, your brain needs to be able to filter out what doesn't need your conscious attention. You need an assistant to screen all your calls, and that's what the RAS does. It focuses your attention on what needs attention and filters out everything else. Here's an example. How aware are you of your breathing? Probably not very often, except for times like this when someone points it out. Most of the time, you just draw in a breath and exhale without giving the process between those two events any thought at all. You don't have to because it's managed on autopilot. It's part of the 400 million pieces of information you subconsciously process every second. But there are times you want to know what's going on. For example, if you're choking and not breathing, you want the message to get through because conscious action is needed. So your reticular activation system lets the call through and draws your attention to the feeling of choking. But that's the exception. The vast majority of your body's functions are managed by that part of you that is way smarter than your thinking mind. Your body routinely handles processes that are really quite miraculous. Another amazing thing about your body is its energy system. In many respects, your body is a machine that converts resources into energy. You eat food, drink water, breathe air, and all that gets transported into our cells where it's converted into energy. This energy then moves you, allows you to think and feel, and keeps the process of life moving along. Anciently, Chinese doctors observed this life process and developed an understanding of energy that's incorporated into what is known as traditional Chinese medicine, or TCM. TCM includes acupuncture, and acupuncture includes acupuncture points and energetic pathways that connect them. These pathways are called meridians. Meridians carry the energy of life called qi, and acupuncture points are gateways that connect the inside of your body's energy system to the outside world. There are 14 main meridians on the body, and most are named after the major internal organ to which it is most closely connected. Along each meridian are situated individual acupuncture points. You might think of acupuncture points as little switches on your body's electrical grid. And you might think of them as antennas, sending and receiving energy and information. This conductivity allows energy to move more freely back and forth between the inside and the outside of your body. The seven chakras, arranged along the spinal cord, are other components of your body's energy system. There are seven main chakras. Each relates to a different part of your body and different aspects of your body's functioning. Like acupuncture points, chakras act as portals that connect your inside to the outside. Over 30 years ago, when I was first introduced to these concepts, they were considered by most Westerners to be strange and mystical. While not yet quite fully accepted or understood by the Western medical establishment, acupuncture and chakra systems have become recognized by millions as a normal part of your anatomy with explainable purposes. Your body's energy pathways transport energy and information. Most of that information is consumed or utilized at the subconscious level, that part of you that is super smart. I suspect you're familiar with this symbol. This side represents yin, and this side represents yang. This symbol represents the concept of opposites, and yin and yang are two opposing categories into which everything in the universe can be placed. For example, yin is cold, yang is hot. Yin is slow, yang is fast. Everything has an opposite. For every yin, there's an equivalent yang. There is opposition in all things. You can sort your body's various parts and pieces into this yin-yang continuum as well. Qi is the most yang part of your anatomy, the energy that flows through your acupuncture meridians. It's the fastest moving, the first to change, and tissue is the slowest, the last thing to change. Even if this concept of qi is new to you, let me assure you that you have more experience with qi than you may realize. Have you ever gotten sick? The first thing that happens is you feel like you're getting sick. That feeling comes from a shift in your qi, because qi is the fastest moving thing in your body. When you get sick, your energy is the first thing to move out of balance. When that happens, you feel it. And when your sickness has run its course and you start to get better, you feel like you're getting better. That's the feeling that comes when your qi moves back to a healthier, more balanced position. Qi is the first thing to move in or out of balance. If you could see your body through an infrared lens, what you would see is energy that extends beyond your skin. This infrared energy is heat, and although heat may have a limited range, a fundamental aspect of energy is that its effects continue on. In other words, the energetic part of you doesn't end at your skin. The sum and essence of you is called your field. Your field is your sphere of influence, and it's not bound by space and time. You really are quite amazing. In this video, we've talked about your body and how it transmits energy and information, and a little bit about your field, your sphere of influence, that extends across space and time. Please continue to join me in the next video where we'll explore fields a bit further. Thanks for watching.